Sterilization and disinfection is a very important step in any dental or surgical procedure. Welcome to Dental and Ayurveda, our channel for basic dental and basic Ayurvedic sciences. और आज हमारा टॉपिक है स्टेरिलाइजेशन एंड डिसइंफेक्शन यूजिंग वेरियस केमिकल मेथड्स ऑफ एन ओटी। बिफोर प्रोसीडिंग आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक यू ऑल फॉर योर सपोर्ट एंड इस चैप्टर के रेडी टू रीड नोट्स अवेलेबल हैं हमारे इंस्टाग्राम या फेसबुक पेज पे जिसका लिंक गिवन है डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में।
स्टेरिलाइजेशन एंड डिसइंफेक्शन। So this is my second video of this topic, and in this video I'm going to discuss about all the chemical methods of sterilization and disinfection. In my previous video that was about physical methods, and now I'm discussing chemical methods. So under chemical methods, a variety of chemical agents, they are used as disinfectants or antiseptics. So you know, an ideal antiseptic or a disinfectant, what all properties it should have. So it should be like, you know, work at a wide spectrum of activity it should have, and it should be effective against all the microorganisms like any bacteria or fungi or viruses. Then act in the presence of organic matters. Then definitely they should have a high penetration power, and they should have a very quick action. Then they should be very effective in acidic medium also, as well as basic medium, and they should be very stable in that. Then it should not corrode the metals. Then it should be also compatible with other disinfectants. Now, not the it should not cause any local irritation, and it should not be toxic also. So it should be safe and easy to use. Then it should be cheap and available, cost effective, and the disinfectant which, you know, possesses all the above criteria, it is not yet to be found. Like, all the properties are not there in the disinfectants that we are using. Then first that I talk about is alcohols. So alcohols are what? These, like ethyl alcohol and isopropyl alcohol. So these are most frequently used, and you know, they act by denaturing the proteins, bacterial proteins को denature कर देते हैं. Then rapid killing of bacteria, including the tubercle bacilli, but they do not have any like sporicidal, virucidal activity. They don't have that. Then mainly as skin antiseptics, it can be used. Like, to be effective, they should be used as a concentration of 60-70%. Okay, in water or methyl alcohol is effective against fungal spores, and it is also used for treating cabinets affected by them. Methyl alcohol vapor is toxic and inflammable. Then I talk about aldehydes. So aldehydes are like formaldehyde. Then basically this is bactericidal, sporicidal, virucidal also. Now it is used like both as aqueous solution and gaseous form में भी हम इसे use करते हैं formaldehyde को. So a 10% aqueous solution of formalin is, you know, used. Now what are the uses of formaldehyde? First is like preservation of any tissue for histological examination, that you can see in your labs also, various organs and you know, these are tissues, these are preserved in formalin. Then to sterilize any bacterial vaccines it is used. Then also to prepare any toxide from any toxin. Then for killing the bacterial cultures and suspensions. And formalin gas jo hoti hai, it is basically described under gases. Then you can see that we can see about these. So this is basically, you know, effective against mycobacterium tuberculosis, fungi and viruses. So this includes all the human immunodeficiency viruses, hepatitis B virus ho ya enterovirus ho. So it is less toxic and irritant to the eyes. Eyes mein less toxic and irritant hota hai to the skin also as compared to formaldehyde. So it is used as 2% buffered solution, and it is available commercially also as Cydex. Now it can be used as delicate instruments having lenses, lenses वगैरह के लिए भी we can use it. Then uses of this will be the for sterilization of cystoscopes, cystoscopes, endoscopes, and bronchoscopes. Then to sterilize any plastic endotracheal tubes or any face masks, inko sterilize karne ke liye we can use it. Even for metal instruments, it is used. Then we talk about phenols. So basically phenols are produced by distillation of coal tar. Coal tar ki distillation se we get phenol between the temperature of 170 degree Celsius to 270 degree Celsius. Iska ek lethal effect bhi hote hai iske kafi due to cell membrane damage. So cell contents kya honge wo release ho jayenge causing lysis. Then 1% phenol, we have also read this in chemistry as well, that 1% phenol, it has a very good bactericidal action. Certain phenol derivatives like cresol or chlorozyrinol, this all this we have heard in chemistry, and these are commonly used as antiseptics. So under phenols we talk about cresols. So basically solution of cresols in soap, this is called Lysol. It is a very common term, Lysol, we all have heard about. So it is most commonly used for sterilization of infected glasswares or any floor cleaning ke liye hum use karte hain. Okay, so they are not readily inactivated by the presence of organic matter. Then we talk about chlorhexidine. So basically Savlon. Savlon, it is very widely used. And hume se wounds mein, you know, in operative disinfection of skin or as a bladder irrigant. So it has wide uses. Savlon is very common that we all use. So it is bactericidal at high dilution. Then they are more active against gram positive than gram negative bacteria, with no action against tubercle bacilli or spores. And viruses ke they have very little activity against viruses. Now fungicidal activity is good. Then we talk about chlorozyrinol. ये काफी एक्टिव इंग्रेडिएंट होता है डिटॉल का. दिस इज फाउंड इन डिटॉल. इफ यू हैव हर्ड अबाउट द कंपोजिशन ऑफ डिटॉल, एंड इट इज वेरी लेस टॉक्सिक एंड लेस इरिटेंट आल्सो. देन वी टॉक अबाउट हेक्साक्लोरोफीन. सो दिस इज मोर एक्टिव अगेंस्ट ग्राम पॉजिटिव एंड ग्राम नेगेटिव बैक्टीरिया. इसे हम स्किन में यूज करते हैं, अप्लाइड ऑन स्किन एज प्रोफाइलैक्सिस अगेंस्ट स्टेफाइलोकोकल इन्फेक्शन. नाउ इट इज ऑल्सो, you know, it is bacteriostatic at very high dilutions, and it is potentially toxic also. So it should be used with care. Then we have halogens. So halogens jo honge, there are two common disinfectants aate hain. We all have heard about this as well, like chlorine and iodine. So chlorine is used in water supplies, okay. Then in swimming pools we have used karte hain, food and dairy products. Now chlorine compounds in the form of bleaching powder, or you can see sodium hypochlorite, okay, and chloramine. So the disinfection action jo hota hai of all the chlorine compounds, ye hota hai kyun? Because of free chlorine release. Now bleaching powder or hypochlorite solution is most widely used disinfectant for any HIV infected material. The hypochlorites have bactericidal and fungicidal action as well as virucidal action. इसके चारों एक्शंस होते हैं. देन आयोडीन इन अल्कोहलिक एंड एक्वो सॉल्यूशन, वी कैन यूज इट एज अ स्किन डिसइंफेक्टेंट आल्सो. कंपाउंड्स ऑफ आयोडीन विद सरफेस एक्टिव एंटीजेंस, दे आर नोन एज आयडोफोर्स. सो आयडोफोर्स जो होते हैं ये मोर एक्टिव होते हैं देन द एक्वस और अल्कोहलिक सॉल्यूशंस ऑफ आयोडीन. बीटाडीन, वी हैव ऑल हर्ड अबाउट बीटाडीन, सो इट इज अ वेरी कॉमन एग्जांपल ऑफ आयडोफोर्स. देन ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स, सो हाइड्रोजन पेरोक्साइड हम यूज करते हैं, दिस इज वेरी इफेक्टिव अगेंस्ट ऑर्गेनिजम्स एट कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ 3 to 6%. While it is going to kill all the organism, including the spores at high concentration, that is 10 to 25%. और इनका मोड ऑफ एक्शन होगा बाय लिबरेशन ऑफ फ्री हाइड्रोक्साइल रेडिकल, ओके, डिकम्पोजिशन ऑफ H2O. नाउ दीज फ्री रेडिकल्स जो होंगे, दीज फ्री रेडिकल्स आर द एक्टिव इंग्रेडिएंट इन द डिसइंफेक्शन प्रोसेस. सो इट इज यूज टू डिसइंफेक्ट द कॉन्टैक्ट लेंसेज आप यूज करते हो, या कोई प्लास्टिक इम्प्लांट्स है तो उसको डिसइंफेक्ट करने के लिए. देन इट इज ऑल्सो यूज फॉर वेरी हाई लेवल डिसइंफेक्शन एंड स्टरलाइजेशन. देन कम्स योर पैरासिटिक एसिड. सो पैरासिटिक एसिड में ये बहुत, इट इज ऑल्सो वेरी गुड डिसइंफेक्टेड एंड इट इज अफेक्टिव, इट इज मोर इफेक्टिव इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक मैटर एंड मोर पोटेंट जर्मिसाइडल एजेंट है दैट देन हाइड्रोजन परऑक्साइड. सो द एंड प्रोडक्ट जो होता है एसिटिक एसिड में ऑक्सीजन, द एंड प्रोडक्ट जो ऑफ दिस एजेंट, दे आर नॉन टॉक्सिक एंड इट इज ऑल्सो यूज इन प्लाज्मा स्टरलाइजेशन प्रोसीजर. This is all about plasma sterilization. You'll see. Now, plasma refers to any gas here. Okay, it refers to any gas which consists of electrons, ions, or neutral particles. So, formation of a low temperature plasma, you know, it requires several devices. इसके लिए काफी सारे devices चाहिए. So, chemical disinfectants such as hydrogen peroxide alone or a mixture of hydrogen peroxide and peracetic acid is used in these devices. Okay, in devices में हम ये combination use करते हैं to induce the plasma. The resulting UV radiation is going to cause the destruction of all the spores and vegetative organisms. Then we have salts. So these salts of heavy metals, they इनका भी एक toxic effect होता है on bacteria. Like salts of copper है, silver हो गया आपके, and mercury, these are used as disinfectants. Then surface active agents. So these substances which alter the energy relationships at interfaces, you know, they are producing a reduction of surface tension. Surface tension reduce karte agents. And most important, antibacterial agent. Then quaternary ammonium compounds are the most important cationic surfactants. So these compounds, they are bactericidal for a wide range of organisms. Gram-positive species are more susceptible. Okay, so they have no action on spores. Yeah, tubercle bacilli, इनका कोई action नहीं होता है. And ये active होते हैं against viruses with lipid envelopes. जो lipid envelopes जिन viruses के होते हैं, they are active against that. And much less against the non-enveloped ones. Like enteroviruses जो होते हैं, वो non-enveloped होते हैं. जो रेबीज वायरसेस होते हैं, दे हैव दैट लिपिड लेयर. देन डाइज. सो डाइज, टू ग्रुप्स ऑफ डाइज, एनिलीन डाइज होती है, एक्रिडीन डाइज होती है. दे हैव बीन लाइक यूज्ड एज स्किन एंड वुंड एंटीसेप्टिक्स. सो बोथ बैक्टीरियोस्टैटिक इन हाई डाइल्यूशन बट लो बैक्टीरिसाइडल एक्शन होता है इनका. देन एनिलीन डाइज जो है, दे आर गोइंग टू इंक्लूड द क्रिस्टल वायलेट, ब्रिलियंट ग्रीन एंड malachite bacteria than gram negative bacteria. Okay, so acridine dyes जो होते हैं आपके पास में, they are going to include the acriflavin, euflavin, proflavin and aminocrine. Okay, so they are also more active against gram positive bacteria than the gram negative bacteria. So gram negative bacteria से ज़्यादा ये gram positive के against active होते हैं, but are not as selective as aniline dyes. Then gases. So first we talk about the formaldehyde gas. So ये fumigation of operation theatres or wards, it is used there. And formaldehyde gas जो होती है, ये कैसे generate होती है? When you add KMnO4 to formalin. जब आप formalin में KMnO4 add करते हो, at that time this is generated. So the door should be sealed and left unopened for 48 hours. Okay. Then sterilization is achieved by condensation of gas on exposed surfaces. So 48 hours के लिए हम इसे unopened रहने देते हैं. Then ethylene oxide. So ये colorless होता है and it is more effective against all types of microorganisms, including the viruses and spores. So ये बहुत highly penetrating gas होती है and it can you know penetrate some plastics as well. So it is specially हम इसे use करते हैं for sterilizing plastics and rubber articles, or for respirators, heart lung machines also. Then dental equipment में भी use करते हैं. Then beta propiolactone. So this is beta propiolactone, BPL. So this is a condensation product of ketone and formaldehyde. So this is also a gas, but it is has a very low penetrating power. Now used for inactivation of vaccines, and it is more efficient for fumigation than formaldehyde. So formaldehyde se zyada ye BPL jo hai, it is more efficient for fumigation. Par iski kuch carcinogenic activities bhi hoti hai.
Thank you for watching. Do like, share and subscribe. Also let us know in the comment box ki aise aur kaun se topics hain jin pe hum aapke liye video bana sakte hain.